Hey there! Welcome to the Knitting Samurai Plus One video podcast. I'm your host, Steph, and this shall be known as the one with the hat, episode 19. It is April 10th, 8 p.m. Roland has gone to bed, and I felt like I should record, but I was in my PJs, and I didn't want to get all dressed and do my hair and get everything back done up for the day, and I said, you know what, they don't care how I look, so you get me with a hat on. It is April 10th, and what's going on? It was a nice sunny day here in New Hampshire, and I took the afternoon off and got my hair cut and colored. It's back there. Again, tied up. Because you know when you get home, you're like, oh, I just want to wash all these hairs off. And so I always take a shower after I get a haircut. But, and I got a pedicure, so my toes are all pretty. I can't believe I just did that for you. But anyways, yeah. So if you're a new viewer, I don't often shove my feet in the camera. But welcome. If you want me to shove my feet in the camera, I'll be more than happy to shove them in the camera for you. If you're a returning viewer, thanks for coming back. I love talking with you guys over on the Wrap Board. It's great to see the membership numbers growing and all the chatter that's going on. So, thanks. So, bum bum bum. Let's get into the knitting for the week. First, on the needles, you've seen them before. The socks for Roland that I was working on. So this is the second pair with the yarn that I really hate, but I'm knitting it for him, and my tag is inside here. What do we say this was? Did I write it down? Patent stretch sock in the olive colorway. So that is a wool, cotton, nylon, elastic blend. I'm still on my first sock, unfortunately, but I did turn the heel, and they are coming along, so. It's that long. There's a little baby heel. I was actually working on these during my pedicure today, and Catherine, the woman that does my nails, was laughing. She was like, oh, baby socks! And I told her the story, if you were around when I was recording the Expectant Knitter podcast, about how I knit 10 pairs of baby socks in the last month while I was expecting, and my giant baby with giant feet, none of them fit him, or one of them fit him for like 2 weeks. One pair fit him. So, anyway, so yes, they are baby socks, but come on, look at that. That's a good size foot. So, we actually went to visit a couple daycares today because we're starting to think about maybe 2 days a week, Ron, going to a daycare to give Steve a bit of a break, give him more time to work on his dissertation. And there were babies in there. The one we went to today, we've been to three now. So the one today, which I absolutely loved, like Steve was laughing at me that I wanted to go be there. Like so much fun in that place. Like the other two, it was like ripping up my heart to think about sending him there. But that one, we got there and the kids, there were six or seven of them there. So tiny. They had a little 3 month, like 3 month and a day old baby girl. Her name was Rowan. Rowan! I was like, is her mother a knitter? And her nickname is Ro-Ro, which is his nickname, so that might be kind of funny. But she was so tiny and so cute. Okay, so last week I showed you my Simmerdam. Well, first, here's my new bag. Did I show you this last time? I don't remember. This is my new Petaloop. It's the large one, and it's owls. It's pink owls. I think I did, because I think I talked about the fact that I'm not a crazy owl person. But anyways, here it is. I love it. Yeah, Roland loves it too. He likes to, I let him play with this one. Since I don't have anything in it and he can't really hurt himself. So my Simmerdam, it, of course the ends are all over the place, but are you noticing? Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. I'll try and be slow about it. It's an F-O. It's an F-O. Yeah. So I finished it and it was interesting to knit. I definitely found the construction to sort of challenge my brain and the way I think about things. It is knit with one skein of socks that rock. So that's 380, 350 yards. I mean, it's not a lot of yardage, so it's clearly a shawlette. It hasn't been blocked. I know it'll block out. If I strangle myself, I might be able to get it this long. But, oh, I'm so sorry. I gotta do it again, though. Yeah, we all had a cold. Anyways, so this is a fun little end. I put it to the wrong side. Anyways, really challenging in terms of, you know, conceptualizing how is this coming together? Two techniques I had not done before. So in that sense, it was an enjoyable knit. I was using my first special yarn that I was saving for a long time. This is the January 1 colorway. Absolutely love it. I don't love it as much knit up as I did in the skein. Oh, break my heart. But at least I'll be getting use out of it. It is a finished shawl. The bind off, when it's blocked, it'll look much, much prettier, I'm sure, when that wants to lay down. But it does have this great pointed bind off. Anyways, my point that I'm trying to get to, in the very long way around, I would have made this. So there's five pattern repeats. If I had realized what was going on, if I were to do it again, I would make it 7 or 8 pattern repeats so that it is a longer shawl, number one. Number two, I definitely won't knit this pattern again. I'm just not that enamored with the finished project. So it was good for a one-time knitting project, but definitely wouldn't redo it. So, and I think that's sort of how I'm going to rate patterns, FOs going forward is, you know, would I redo it? Would I do it again? Did I enjoy it? Things like that. Like the stuff I just talked about. I'm going to try and do a better job reviewing patterns for you so that you get a better sense of, you know, just what I think about what I'm knitting. So get another knitter's perspective. So there you go. That is finished. And that is my second shawl in 2011. I am trying to knit 12 in 2011. So if we do my little rundown and we count up the yardage, I have knit 2,792 yards so far this year. So I've still added more than that. So we'll keep doing these prize drawings until I get it flush. So anyways, yay, that's done. But now my shawl bag here is empty. But I've been dreaming about this yarn. So this is the Alicia Goes Around Panoply of Peacocks, I think is what it is. Panoply of Peacocks in the Deciduous colorway. This is an awesome green color. Green, black, and all the shades in between. It's a great, I don't know, you've heard me talk about this yarn before. I absolutely love it. So I am thinking my next shawl, I want to get it right on the needles real quick here. There are four options, so I'd like to say tell me what you think. I don't know that I will wait long enough to hear what you have to say. But if you'd like to leave a comment on the episode with your opinion, I'd appreciate it. I just might not listen, or I might only listen to the first person. So the four shawls I'm thinking about are the Maluka by B. Schmidt. I'll link these in the show notes. The Boneyard Shawl by Stephen West, and I'm thinking if I do the Boneyard or one of his other solid colored shawls, I could do it for the Knittables Knit Along, so bonus, might do that. The Coleus by Kristen Kapoor, the Contrast and Compliment, which somebody in the group is knitting and they posted it and it was like, oh my god, I have to have that, by Inez Andelzane, I don't know, Inez Andelzane. Anyways, but that would be a two color. Oh my god, my nose. What is going on? So one of those four shawls. If you have an opinion, if you've knit one and have some advice about it, please let me know. Post a comment on the thread. I would appreciate that. All right, what else is going on the needles? I wanted to knit Roland a baby hat. Well, I wanted to knit Roland lots of things. So he has his center two front teeth here on the bottom, and they've come in quite a bit, and they're so bright white, and they're so cute. And I thought, oh, Rebecca Danger, Toothy Joe, like, it would be fitting to knit a monster. Don't have the book here, sorry. To knit a monster that has, like, a tooth. Like, most of her monster teeth are off to the side, but I thought I'd put two in the middle, and it would be a good toy for him now. Yeah, no. I cast on using Knit Pick Swish size set with size 7 needles, and I think the base of it, I got probably a fifth of the way into it, but enough so that I could see how big the body was going to be. It's going to be like this big round. That's not the size monster I want. So I still would like to knit him a toothy Joe, and maybe I will, but it's going to be with fingering weight, because the Louie the Love Bud I knit, I really like how that came out with tiny needles. So that's coming. Ripped. Started ripped and in purgatory or something. But then I cast on a hat for him because Bad Mommy, who knits, he only has one hat right now that fits him. And I know it's April, but I still wanted him to have a hat. So I cast on using some of the leftover Patton's Croix that I had knit him a sweater for Thanksgiving with. I don't know if I just showed pictures of him in that on here, but I can... Here, look at the sweater. Anyways, it's a yoke sweater. Details in the show notes. And I had a little tiny bit left, and I thought, because I love the color progression of this yarn, and I love the fact that it looks handspun because of the barber pole effect of it, and it does this great color change throughout. And I saw how it knit up on the sleeves, knitting the round, versus on the body, knit flat. And so let's see how it looks knitting the round on a hat. So I cast on, and I was going gangbusters last weekend, and he has a big head. And so I sort of overestimated how big his head was, and I knit a hat that was too big for my head, too big for Steve's head, too big for everybody. It was about that big around. It was massive, and I got knit to the end. I was out of yarn, and I was like, oh no, what am I going to do? And at that point I thought, oh, let's split it onto two needles and just see how much more yarn I need. And when I did that, I was like, oh dear God, this is a massive hat. So I pulled back, I frogged back all the way to my increases, right? And then did a few fewer, and actually measured my gauge at that point and said, oh, knitting on US size 3s with fingering weight yarn, I'm actually getting 8 stitches to the inch, not 6. Who knew? So here's my second attempt. I've done a few more rows past where I ripped back to, but I'm really not motivated. Like, it ate up all my motivation, and I had to put it in timeout for a while, and while it was in timeout, I still wanted to knit a baby hat for Roland. So I pulled out another skein of Patton's Croix sock stripes that I have. I went through a phase there where I bought quite a bit of this. I probably have 4 or 5 sets. Anyways, and it's more of a sport weight yarn than a fingering weight yarn, so I don't want to knit socks with it. At least not socks for me and my shoes. But I really like it for hats, and so I cast on, and see, I'm stretching out the ribbing all the way, because he does, he's 19 inches. I mean, it's a pretty big squash. So, so that's how much I've completed so far, using US size 3s. And what color is this? Would you like to know? It is called Cyan Stripes. So, that's that one, and the other one, I can't tell you. Well, see, you know, when you hand wind a ball, I always put my label on the inside and wrap around that. So, can't tell you, but those, so I'm sort of racing myself because I have mojo and determination for this one, and I don't for this one. And I have to tell you that while I was working on this weekend, it was raining and gray and depressing out, and I was listening to Catching Fire, the second book in the Hunger Games, and I wasn't at a part I liked, and I didn't like what was going on. This just has bad juju. It doesn't make me feel happy. Like, I look at it, and I think of how miserable the capital is, and everything about the Hunger Games, which I'm right now the first third of Mockingjay, and it's all I can do to listen to it. Like, my brother-in-law told me that they were dark. Like, when he finished reading them, he was like, oh, God, Steph, I gotta listen, or I gotta, he doesn't listen, he reads. I gotta read something happier, because this is depressing. And it very much reminds me of the way I felt reading 1984. Like, oh, this society is so draining, and oh, thank God I don't live there. But it doesn't make me feel happy. It's not a happy thank God, it's just a, oh, those poor people. So, anyways. I don't like reading books that elicit those kind of emotions out of me. I'd rather read books that make me happy or intrigue me and make me wonder about the strategy behind it. See, Game of Thrones. Anyway, so hats for Roland are on the needle. And Downton Abbey, Age of Brass and Steam Shawl. Dreaming Color Classy, Smushy. Smushy. Didn't Get Any Love. I've already shown you this. I think that you've seen everything I'm working on this week. That's it. So this is sort of random. I don't know what caused me to... How did I find that? I found some listing of the top 30 cult movies. I'll link it. It's a TV guide listing top 30 cult TV shows of all time, not movies. And I was reading them out loud. Well, we played a guessing game, and so Steve was trying to name them, and we were both just like flabbergasted with what they came up with. So I'll link it, and you can go look at their listing. But I'm going to give you my listing. So 10. Okay, so I actually have 13 shows listed, but I'm only going to tell you what I think are the top 11. Why 11? I don't know. Because I was like splitting hairs between 10 and 13. So, 10 and 13? No, 10 and 11. So the number 11, which I would describe these as sort of outside of pop culture, but yet super loyal following. So get it in your head what you think number one is, what number one should be anyways. The way TV Guide described it was cult followings in terms of the viewers buy everything they can find themed and go to Comic-Con or those type of shows dressed up as characters. So I read that and I was just like, oh, I know how I got to this. Okay, back up. I'll tell you the beginning of the story, which is I joined the Into the World Yarn Club. Not the fiber, I don't spin, but the Yarn Club. And the first shipment, or the first three shipments I'm signed up for are Firefly. And I love Firefly. So then I was like, I'm gonna watch Firefly. And then I was looking online just to get to look at some images to see if maybe I could find what she was going to use for inspiration, like if there was a nice picture and then she used those colors, because she definitely has to use yellow and brown for the Firefly itself and the brown coats or something, right? And so I'm looking around and I go to the Wikipedia page and it lists it as a cult following and with a link to this TV guide thing, which is how I got there. Okay. So now you kind of know where I'm coming from. So here's number 11 according to Knitting Samurai, Family Guy. I know, who's got taste? But they repeatedly go right over that line. But when you think about it, the show was on for 3 or 4 years, canceled, viewers brought it back. Like, they loved it so much they restarted it, whatever, turned it back on. So you have to have a good fan base, cult following type for that. Number 10. Futurama. Same situation, except I actually love Futurama. I've probably watched an episode of Futurama every day of my life since, I can't believe I'm admitting this, since 2001 when it was on Adult Swim. And like every night we'd end up watching that. I don't know why. Well, I was in college at the time. So I love Futurama again. Another one canceled, brought back. Handful of movies out there. Hilarious. One of my girlfriends knit me a bender. He's probably yay high. Like, he's this giant robot and he's so cute. Yeah. I came up with some patterns for brain slugs. Like, Futurama, it's like a family thing. Steve and I, it's something that we both can watch, recite all the lines, think it's hilarious. I think there are Simpsons fans out there that have a similar connection with Simpsons. I don't, but whatever. Number 9, Firefly, because it's all the F's right together. Number 8, according to me, would be Stargate. I'm saying SG-1, I guess. I don't know. I tried to watch Stargate, but never really got into it. But I know there are people that are massively huge fans of it, so I'm kind of thinking about Karen and what she talks about watching here. So Buffy is number 7. Buffy the Vampire Slayer. When it was on, I didn't watch it, but there's a huge following for that show. Anything Joss Whedon, really. But We went through them all. I think I own the first 5 seasons and really should rewatch it. That it's been so long that it would be new to me. But that is not my favorite Joss Whedon. And neither is Firefly. And my favorite, I don't think the rest of the world likes it, so I didn't put it on my list. That's how unbiased I was trying to be. Okay, number 6. Star Trek Next Generation. I know. The TV Guide list doesn't even include them. Next Generation? Are you kidding? That's the best Star Trek. Okay, number 5. X-Files. X-Files, yes. There are some very crazy people that are into that show. I got through, I think, 6 or 7 seasons streaming on Netflix, and then it was just like, meh. It didn't make me happy enough, and I wasn't really connected to Scully or Mulder. Enough to keep watching and stay committed. So, but X-Files was number 2, according to TV.
Number 4
would be Monty Python, according to me. A lot of guys in my high school quoted that show, and that was their deal. So I think there's a huge following out there for that. And then, number 3, according to me, as I see it, is Battlestar Galactica. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. The new version. The 2000s version, anyways. It's classic. I love it. It's such a good show. There's so many layers going on there. Definitely worth watching if you've never watched it. Number 2, alright, think about it. Think about all of those knitters and podcasters out there that you've seen showing their little bags, project bags, and saying, "It's Doctor Who! Yes!" We buy all we can find. For some reason, knitters love Doctor Who. Oh crap, there's a cat scratching. Number 2, Doctor Who. Oh, David Tennant, I love you, you're my doctor. Although he was not my first doctor, which I know you're supposed to love your first doctor, but he's the one I love. I grew up with my dad making me watch Star Trek Next Generation and Doctor Who and Is It's Here. That's what I was just looking at. She was talking to me. Is It Is a Cat. I'm not crazy. Anyways, yeah, so he made me watch those shows growing up. Hated them. As an adult, loved them. And then, number 1, think about all of those crazy people that go to Comic-Con all dressed up in the suits. And we're talking shows, not movies, because I know you're thinking of Here She Comes. Is it? No. I know you're thinking about Star Wars as well, but Star Trek. Yes, Star Trek, the original series, classic. I tried to watch one episode and was so completely offended by the sexism in it that I couldn't stand it. But I do appreciate that there are people out there that love it, and it's just not a show for me. Anyways, this week, let's have the prize drawing be to be entered into it. Leave a comment of what you think the top 5 cult TV shows are. Or if you are a crazy person who is super in love with Doctor Who, and you just, all you can see is Doctor Who, then just list what you think is number 1 for you. So, either way, either you have your favorite cult following, or you're an outsider looking and going, yeah, that's what those people like. And the yarn for this week is Buckingham by Bristol Yarn Gallery. It's an 80% baby alpaca, 20% silk. Yes, you can see there is a cat on camera with the yarn. I make no bones about it. It is a beautiful purple color. Can you see it? This is super soft. I bought a bag of this at Webb's forever ago, and that's 10 skeins of 210 yards each of a fingering weight yarn. I'm never going to knit all of this into shawls. Like, I'm not going to knit a giant shawl. And now if I knit one shawl out of it, I'm not going to want to knit a second one. So I'm going to share it with you guys. So this is about 660 yards. And that is up for the grabs this week. So, leave a comment if you're interested. Anyways, that is my take on the top 11 cult TV shows. Maybe you're on my yard. I'm in my yard. My notes, come sit on me. Alright, so what else do I have to tell you about? I think it's time to do the April birthday drawings, and I just want to say happy birthday to 9 grands for Graham. It is her birthday today, April 10th. But we have bringing up the computer here. We have 26 members with April birthdays. Getting all my technology going. So I'm going to go to random.org and put in numbers 1 through 26. Oh, would you like to see the yarn before I jump ahead? So the birthday yarn is going to be a skein of Noro Silk Garden regular. It's not Silk Garden light. It is color 203 lot B, which is a 45 silk, 45 kid mohair, 10% wool yarn. This is a great gray, blue, green color. Very masculine. I had cast on for a hat, so there is a little bit of winding here. But whole skein's here. You can make something wonderful using Noro. So we are going to generate and maybe throw Is It off the desk. You know, there are no cats, and then the cat can't get enough attention. And wants to dump over my water. Yes, I'm using a baby poop to soak up my water. All right, generate there, you. Clicking the button, spinning. I used to listen to Stitch It. I love Megan. Sadly, not anymore. Not that I don't love her, she just doesn't podcast. And yeah, I don't know. Is my internet connection down? What's going on? Because this is already a super long episode. Generate. Okay, number 4. So in the birthday list, number 4 is Kristen R. Her birthday is April 2nd. Happy birthday, Kristen. Shoot me a private message with your address and I will get this in the mail to you. Yay! All right, next up in our prize drawing madness, we are going to do... What are you doing, random.org? You're driving me crazy. Making me look like a fool. Cut it out. We are going to do the plus one member drawing. Thank you to all the new people who joined. I hope you're enjoying the show and you continue watching. Come back often. We had an amazing jump this week and went from 309 members to 500 members. So that is 350, 400, 450, 500. 4 prize drawings that I get to give away. So every member is eligible. So I am going to generate 500. The first yarn that we're doing is Barocco Ultra Alpaca Fine. This is like a brick red colorway. It is 50% wool, 20% super alpaca, and 30% nylon. 433 yards. So that is the first one. Clicking generate. It's going, gone. Why is this being so slow? And am I going to have to be like everyone else and do it ahead of time? Seriously, I didn't realize. I haven't done a lot of prize drawings besides recently. Yeah, I don't know. What the heck? I wonder if it would be faster on my computer. Why would this be taking so long? I am just babbling at this point. Yes. No. Random.org. Hold on. All right. The first one is number 416. I don't know if you can see that. So member 416 is York Set. York Set. I can't say your Laritza. It was really nice. Last week I pronounced everybody's names wrong, and when they sent me PMs, they all told me how to pronounce their names, so that's nice to know how to say them. So York Set, send me a PM, and I will shoot this off in the mail to you. Let us generate for the next one. Number 499. How lucky is that? And that is member Deldaria, Wendy. So, Wendy Deldaria, you are winning a skein of Alpaca with a Twist Highlander, 45% baby alpaca, 45% merino wool, 8% microfiber, 2% viscose, 145 yards. It's either an Aran, I think it's an Aran weight. It says US size 9. So, and it's this beautiful tweed green yarn. Great for fingerless mitts. That's what I got it for. So, Deldaria, shoot me a line to let me know. All right, and we're going to generate another one. Member 88, one of the original few, old school, is Mama Ophelax and Lizzie. Mama of Alex and Lizzie. I got it! All right, so you are winning a skein of 3U's Twisted in Fiber, U Bamboo in the color Sangria. It is 80% merino and 20% bamboo. It is a lovely red color and 430 yards. So shoot me a PM and I will get that off in the mail for you. And one more to generate. Here we go. I came up with one. I'm number one. That doesn't work. Okay. Number 37. Dun, dun, dun. Much better with it going fast here. Number 37 is Ad Knitter 00. Kara. So, Kara, shoot me a line and I'll drop this in the mail. You are getting two skeins of Plymouth Yarn Fantasy Naturelle, 100% mercerized cotton, and each skein is 140 yards, and this is definitely worsted weight, US size 8s, so a bright green and a nice red to go with that. So again, PM me and I will shoot that off for you. So there you go, ladies and gentlemen. There are the drawings, except for one. So the one that you most care about, I'm saving it for the end. That's for last. So the cakewalk yarn, let me get into that thread on Ravelry. The cakewalk drawing, we had 69 comments. I think a couple of those were me. I couldn't help it. Some people painted really cute pictures of what their ideal knitting weekend yarn escape would be. So, far and away, fingering weight yarn is the favorite amongst the group. So, numbers 1 through 30 up for this skein of Smirk in Cakewalk, what's it called? Footsie yarn. Generate. It came up with number 25. So let us see who number 25 is. I think that's going to be on the second sheet of answers. Come on, Ravelry. Nope. It's going to be the last one on the first page. It is Big Ash Dog. So what she had to say, who is Becky from St. Louis. And what Becky said is, the trouble is that my favorite silk or cashmere fingering weight yarns are waiting for the perfect storm of pattern and mojo to happen. Ain't that true, sister? If I suddenly have a great knitting weekend pop up, I'd probably just open the drawers on my stash cabinet and choose the color that inspires me the most, but not one of the perfect high pressure yarns. I then comb Ravelry for a pattern that looks fun and functional and get to it. Can you tell I read a lot of children's stories and we have to do voices? So get in touch with me, Big Ash Dog, and this will be coming to you, my dear. And I think that's all I've got for you this week. It's going to be another long episode, that the drawing makes it take a little longer. I hope you guys don't mind. And I really appreciate watching, and I really appreciate you helping me clean up this stash. So, I hope you have a great knitting week, and I will talk to you soon. All right. I'm sorry. I'm totally distracted. I never have the computer screen open, and I'm looking at Raylan 01, who I remember when she was pregnant. She's got a new picture up of her two little kids as her avatar, and I think it's Suri is her little girl. I'm not sure, but they are the cutest things. Little boys, completely adorable. So, anyways, I'll probably link her in the show notes because now I've told you all about it, and you should go look at this adorable child. Anyways, that's it from...